Well, it's great to be back outside again. I finally got my bucking station put back together and I only needed a little bit of help with the grapple and getting these big logs up. I did it 3 pallets high. I know I'm short, but I figure less bending the better. So I'm gonna give you a look at it. So I put it 3 pallets high. And I put these oak stakes in, kind of hold everything. I've got 2 large pieces of cedar here and 1 piece of pine that I have used before. My other pine was rotten, so I've tried to switch it up to cedar. I've had a little bit of extra cedar, so I cut those into 16s and then I'm going to split those. And hopefully I'll get my wood moved and we'll be getting everything back right with the world. I say that because Larry's down clearing out a new area for my wood stand. So let's go see what he's doing. We had a bus shelter down here for 25 years. The kids probably never used it, but they were supposed to. Oh my, the bus shelter is gone. Torn out the fence. So what basically we were told is if my wood stand was on state property, that pretty much there wasn't anything the police could do with people who stole from it. But that if we had it back here on our property, which we will, that they could prosecute people who steal from it. And we found a new camera system, which I hate going this way, but we're gonna have to. If I wanna have a wood stand, and I'd really like having a wood stand. We'll be getting our new shirts and stickers from Backspin Graphics here soon. Who knows, it may already be in the mailbox. First thing I'm gonna do is go through the mailing list we have and mail it to everybody. Give me about 2 weeks. If you haven't received one and you want one, email us at outdoorswithlarryandrobin@gmail.com and send me your address and I'll certainly send you one.
This is where the bus shelter used to be, and we took it out and I took out fence up to there. So my thinking is I'm going to put a wood stand right here, and then someone that wants wood can drive in beside it. So we're going to put his neighbor here, well, you can't see it, over on his road. That's where we sold, it's property we sold. He's got this black mat landscape or whatever you put under driveways. He's nice enough to give us what's left. We got a pretty good size roll. So we're gonna put that down to control the weeds, hopefully.
Yeah, we got some serious honeysuckle problems.
Honeysuckle and weeds, I tore out most all of it. But That's the plan here.
And then you're going to do some railroad ties, and we're going to eventually do gravel?
Well, we're going to look at it in here, because it's a real good homemade muggly thing. So we'll probably do some railroad ties around it. Anyway, that's the plan. We're going to split some on the crimson here. So she's going to put the MX-51 bucket on it. It's a little bigger bucket. Good bit bigger bucket, but lady in her tractor. Bucket test, all good.
of the month. Right up into orbit, my chicks the all abound. A land earth flag's a problem, a rent being overdue. What possible solution? I haven't got a clue. But at the end of the day, at the end. So that the end.
What?
Still doesn't have you.
Sorry. I just looked in it. You know, if I left some of this in this bucket, I would already have it ready for when our guests come. Instead of emptying it all.
Yeah, because there's always some in the bin that could be resplitting.
We're not going to be resplitting, we're filling bags. And if I'm filling bags, I do the bag here and fill it from the bucket. Alright, let's empty the bucket and then resplit when
we come. I mean, there's no verification right yet.
Right, but I'm going to still fill the bags from this bucket. King value meals, I guess. There you get two junior whoppers, two fries,
two value drinks,
yeah, for like
11 bucks.
Okay, anyway, we wanted to thank you all for watching.
Yep, appreciate it.
And thank all our subscribers,
everybody.
Thank everybody who subscribed and anyone who, jeez, okay, I give up. Thanks, bye.